you went to Paris and you assume that you have earned money and you have come to Paris. That means your earning money record has been created at that moment by the thought. Which is not, is it true, real record? False. A false record has been created at that moment. Are we clear?
Mm.
So that means a false record can be created by thought at any point of time.
Yeah.
Is that clear to you?
Yes.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
I have a question.
May we come to first? Okay. Any point of time, thought can create a false record. I have given a proof to you.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
By your own experience, dream experience.
Okay.
But then you say, don't can't say it's a dream. That time it's real for you.
Yes.
Okay.
That's right.
Right. So that first, my lord, point number one.
It's clear.
Thought can create a false record at any point of time.
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So now second question. Right now, are you awake or dreaming?
Dreaming.
Can you prove me you are not dreaming?
No.
I can
convince that you are dreaming.
I can prove. I'm not dreaming, I'm just pinching and she's
How do you know you are not dreaming now?
Yeah.
Huh. As long as thought is there, I am dreaming. Okay? You are no point after you can find out what is real and what is dreaming. Because when you are dreaming, the dream appears to be real. Okay? Now is this real?
No.
It is real now. Because it's real now, you cannot find out whether it's dream or reality. So this could be as well be a dream. This could as well be your thought which has created a history of last class. Disprove it.
Ramani ji.
Yeah.
You can make a phone call also.
But that, if remember, all that is in a dream. In the dream, Ramani also gets created.
She is also dreaming that I had a class in my
dream. No. You create Ramani in the dream also.
I know.
And she will say whatever you want her to say.
Correct.
So. Wait. First, let us confuse these people thoroughly and then we will go to next point.
He will forget.
So, this, as long as there are thoughts, the thoughts can create a history which doesn't exist. Okay?
It can create. But, see, when I create a thought, when the thought creates an imagination, like I can imagine now I'm sitting there. Like even during the class, why do we say the mind wandered or the mind is roaming? Is because the thought started. Some other thought started and I got distracted. It's always there. But at the next moment, I will become aware that the mind wandered and there was a distraction. There is awareness, right? Similarly, the thought can create an imagination and the awareness will say it was an imagination.
May or may not.
But still, I agree. May or may not. Then we just continue with
the
that.
The moment you say may or may not, it's not certain.
See from the Sakshi's point of view, it is not certain. From the Sakshi's point of view, there is nothing called past, present. From that is from the Sakshi's point of view. Even if the awareness comes now, I may not ask all these questions because it doesn't make any sense to ask so many questions. If the awareness is there, that you are beyond all this, the moment the awareness comes, you forget everything. That is the power of awareness. But what we are asking is, it may or may not, the thought can create anything as an imagination. Yes, it can. But at the same time, why do we suffer or why do we hang on to our past is because it starts recollecting something that is recorded. And I agree, even the recording may not be permanent, like is not the 100% accurate. The recording can take its own imagination, because when she says something to me, I can imagine she would have said from different perspective and I can imagine something else. I agree. All those things will happen, but still there is a record, okay? And that past is the trouble that we are all facing, because if that was not there, naturally we need not...
I go step by step. First, I have proved that a thought can create a past history which doesn't exist or which might be a vague but it's recreated.
Yes.
Yeah.
In
yes.
case of dream.
Yes.
So, I am saying waking state is no different from your dream state.
Yes.
Do you have a dispute on that?
No.
What about functional memory?
From the functional
memory. Learn to drive or...
I'll come to that. Next, give me next step. Right? So, there is a possibility of past being recollected. Then, next question, being the waking state is not no being different past. You can accept that the past can be created at any moment by a thought.
Yes.
Whether it can do it or not, we'll find out.
Yeah.
Okay. So, the waking state is slightly different from the dream state in the sense that the dream state is also a subset of waking state. Okay, even though they are similar, they are a subset. So, waking state itself will take. Waking state, the memory is there. Let's say she attended a class. I attended a class, memory is there. Now, I'll ask the question, who attended the class? Who attended the class?
The body, mind and intellect.
The body, mind and intellect, in 1 week, has it same, remained same or changed?
Changed, obviously.
It has changed.
Yes.
So the body, mind, intellect has changed, but recording has it changed?
No.
I mean, if you recollect?
No.
So then you say, I attended a class, is it true?
Okay, body, mind attended the class.
The body, mind attended the class, I mean, 1 week is too short, maybe 2 years, let's say. Is it same today?
No, it is not the same.
But that memory is there.
No. I am saying, please understand. So, I attended the class 2 years back. Is it true?
From the memory perspective, it is true. From the memory perspective, it is true.
What is true was there was an experience of the class.
Yes.
I attended the class is false.
Okay.
Okay.
The class has been in the whole thing. No. Earlier you said it's creating. Now you are saying, okay,
Arre
body,
Baba,
mind, intellect has attended.
Listen carefully, step by step. She said, 1 week back I attended the class. The I attended the class is false. Because
okay.
Sakshi is not changed.
Even the event also maybe didn't happen. It got recreated. By the time I'm getting convinced that it's getting recreated, you said, no, it happened. The body has attended, but Sakshi didn't. Again, you're shifting.
I am taking point by point, not shifting.
You have changed the viewpoint.
Because we are not yet convinced.
So, right now I am saying, okay, how recreation is happening, again I will tell you. So, there is an event which happened 1 week back. I attended the class is true.
No, maybe the thought recreated it now.
You
said when thought can create false history, it may be false. How can you again say that no, it happened?
I am covering all the cases of situations.
Which
functional memory I have to account for, no?
Functional
memory or driving car and all I have to say, no?
Yeah.
So, I attended the class last week. Is it true or false?
False from
your point of view. Because your body has changed, mind has changed, intellect has changed.
But the memory is the same.
So that's where I'm saying the memory is creating the same, it is not the same. That's why it's false.
Unless it attended the class, it would not have created the same memory.
Are you not able to find the different, this thing? The one who attended the class and one who is speaking now, they are different from body-mind complex point of view.
Yeah.
Sakshi doesn't claim that. The body-mind point of view claims that I attended the class and I am here.
Mm.
But the Ganvai who attended the class has changed now.
Okay.
So you are not
attended
the
class.
Moment guy who is there in this moment is not attended the class. But memory is creating impression that you attended the class.
Yep.
I will say Asha attended the class. Asha attended the class.
Who is Asha?
Who is Asha?
No. The previous version of this body mind intellect.
See. Are you not able to see the superimposition? The one who is permanent there is Sakshi.
Yes.
The memory is taking the Sakshi part who is there in that and changing part here and superimposing. And I only attended the class, which is recreating a history.
Yeah, recreating a history based on memory.
Which memory?
that's what we are saying.
Where is this memory coming from then? Sakshi is not worried.
Your first body question mind energy. Who is recording? Who is the recorder?
Sakshi doesn't record.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Sakshi doesn't record.
Yes.
The Chidabhasa and Buddhi, this combination is working as a body mind complex.
Okay.
Chidabhasa doesn't change, but it appears to be changing. Okay. So this combination attended a class 1 week back. Okay. At that moment, that is the experience of Sakshi. The Sakshi is one way that has disappeared. Now only present is there. So now again you come back. Now you are claiming that I attended the class. Okay. Where is this I? I is nothing but Sakshi, which is permanent. The body, mind and intellect which has changed now. Right? So you are saying, but now for the Sakshi's point of view, this is present moment. In the present moment, you are trying to superimpose a past event and saying that happened. But that happened only in the present for Sakshi.
So that happened. At least that is true.
That happened and disappeared. Okay. So now next, another event is happening. For another event, a continuity is given, taking the event which has happened and disappeared, saying that it has happened. But this event doesn't remember, know it, but it is recreating, there is a continuity.
Continuity is taken from?
Yeah, that is where? The whole question.
Continuity is taken from Sakshi, the presence.
Taken from where?
Huh?
Where?
Sakshi.
Sakshi always there.
Sakshi doesn't record anything. Back to the square one.
Sakshi doesn't record anything. Okay. But the I, which was there earlier, now from the mind point of view, that is used as a reference of I experienced it. So this moment is a completely new thought with the history, not based on the event, but based on the presence of the Sakshi as continuity.
Guruji, you said that a thought can create a false history at any point of time.
Yes, it can.
Yeah, it can create any history. Yeah, it's a false history anyway.
Yeah.
So it can create a false history at any point of time, any moment.
Yes.
Yeah, any thought
can. Yes, but history, there's two parts to history. The presence is coming from Sakshi anyway.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
That is true. There's continuity there, but continuity is not because of thought.
Yeah.
The continuity itself is there, but not because of thought. Okay.
It's borrowed from the Sakshi.
Continuity is borrowed from Sakshi. But the current event, okay, assumes something has happened earlier. But happened earlier, who was present is Sakshi. Okay, remaining things are filled up. I only experienced it.
Event happened earlier.
The event is continuously happening and disappearing. No. Event is at moment to moment, it's happening and disappearing.
So you are saying last week a class happened. That is true. I didn't attend.
Sakshi's point of view, the present, it is a present moment. It's not last week or
present.
Today.
Yeah.
It is a present moment. The class happened.
So is it like this? Last week, class happened and it is done, finished.
It's over.
So
it appeared and disappeared.
My recollection is the thought is giving continuity to it. Or the imagination
the continuity
is dragging it to this moment.
Thought in time and space.
It is dragging to this moment. Again,
yes,
continuity is happening. Okay. It is not memory which is dragging. Imagination which is dragging. That is the point.
The one that has come and
imagination
gone is being dragged.
Including the time and space and making it continuous.
The imagination. See, there is nothing permanent other than Sakshi.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, at this moment, again, even event has happened.
Hmm.
Now that event, there's nothing permanent left there, because other than Sakshi, nothing is there. The what is bringing, okay, I experienced all these things, is the continuity is coming from Sakshi, recreation is coming from, recreating of that event or associate thing is coming from imagination.
So what you said in it's false history. So it happened, right? You are not denying the fact that the class didn't happen last week. You are not denying the fact.
First, you tell me, did you attend the class last week?
No,
I am not denying. You are.
The event, Guruji, will not talk about who attended. We will only talk about if the event happened or not.
The event happened and disappeared.
Okay, it happened.
It's not a false history.
But event is also thought.
Event also is thought. Appeared and disappeared. Right?
Then why are you saying it's false history? False history means the event didn't happen at all. At this moment, it's creating a fresh history saying that event happened, which didn't happen actually.
If I answer that question, I'll go into next level of logic before I... yeah, okay. So if I answer that question, I'll go into next level. In your Paris, in your dream, you went to Paris.
Yes.
Was that really event happened?
No, it never happened. It's created.
So that event is that also moment. An imagination.
So that event happened also is imagination, just like your dream.
That is clear to me.
Now to go to Paris, I need...
Okay. I mean, you are mixing up too much. Logic by
yeah,
logic, you understand. Okay, then you put together. Okay, you are putting together too many things. Okay, exactly. Then you are trying. Huh? Okay.
Like if now, in the second I sleep, and that second, and then I wake up.
Wake up.
The second I dream for 1 year.
Right.
Okay. So when that 1 year dream started, so starting, as you told, I imagine.
Yes, imagine.
That there was a. Was born and there is a father, there is mother, there is I am born in India and
right,
I am like that. I attended the class and everything. Then the next moment happens. In next moment, as per dream, actually as per me, who is the dreamer, there is nothing is happening. In that one second.
As per Sakshi.
That is, Sakshi means the dreamer. Now I am talking from the point of view that I am here and I have just slept and I have just come out. And then that, from my point of view, when I wake up, nothing has happened.
Nothing
that dream is nothing is.
There is nothing is there.
So from that there is falsehood. There is nothing has happened.
Right.
So it's all imagination. Now from the dreamer point of view, in that 1 year when I was dreaming, so in that 1 year actually moment event happened. So you are telling that the moments which has happened from the dreamer point of view, nothing happened. From the character in that dream,
yes,
that he feels that from his point of view also that whatever has happened. It is like that, it is not like a continuous, the character is not continuous, the character is like being recreated continuously in the dream itself.
Yes.
And in the dream itself is also unreal.
Correct.
So dream is unreal and in that character also, that is also unreal.
Yes. That's right.
Correct. No?
That's
and
exactly.
This time also, that 1 year
time also
that
unreal.
Is also unreal because that 1 year has never happened.
What happened in the dream exactly is happening now also.
So that we can come only after we
so ultimately
up.
When I wake
first,
up
first time
all this becomes a dream.
Who has to wake up?
Somebody. Yeah, one who is sleeping.
Who has to, first you understand what's happening exactly. He explained very clearly, right?
Yeah.
A dream. Okay, 1 year passed, 2 year passed. Was it real? But it's real when you are dreaming.
Yeah.
Okay, it's absolutely real. I give example, Narada had 6 children also. He followed Vishnu also. So it's absolutely real when you are dreaming. Are we clear? And the dream, any thought can be, history can be created by any thought. This much is clear to you?
Yes.
Okay. Now you wake up. You say, nothing happened really. No event happened really. All are imaginations.
False.
Clear? So now next point I'll say to my dear, you cannot distinguish right now what you are experiencing is dream or reality because they have same quality.
Okay.
Then whatever applies, logic applies to the dream applies here also.
So this is also a dream. From the Sakshi's point of view, this is also dream is acceptable. But for the functioning of this body, mind,
ha,
intellect.
So,
I cannot say that anyway this is a dream. And if I simply say
no.
My
dream when it happens, dream when it's happening, it appears to be real. Okay, dream when your tiger comes, you'll have to run. But after waking up, you say, it is a dream tiger. Are we clear?
Yeah.
And dream memories are also false.
No, but there's still, there is a memory that I had a dream, at least when you wake up. There is a memory that recollects and says that I had a dream.
Now in the dream I
so right now, I am saying
I am in dream.
Right now I am saying you don't know whether you are in dream also. Right now you are waking or dream. You can't find out. There is difference is very little.
Acceptable.
So
I
whatever logic
I am dreaming. In that case, for this functioning, there is a memory which is recording or recollecting. Something is traveling. But if we say this mind cannot record because it's a temporary going and coming, and Sakshi is permanent but it doesn't do any activity,
because it doesn't need to do any activity. In that case, there is some other entity which is recording and recollecting.
There is no some other entity, that's the point. Okay, this moment, imagination of consciousness.
But what I'm saying is the imagination is itself. But still the imagination is limited to, like Vayashi said, for the driving, the imagination cannot start from that moment, right? It recollects something that I learned and then only it starts. The imagination starts from some reference. The imagination
in the car is like
the imagination starts with a reference. The imagination just doesn't happen. For imagination, it needs some reference. It needs some record.
So you are saying, Guruji,
event happened. Okay, the event dissolved. Another event came and that dissolved.
Yes.
The another event came with the imagination that the previous event was happened. There happened. So now in the functional
that
memory,
imagination will happen only when the event happened. If otherwise, the imagination will not say the event happened, right? Otherwise, it will say it's imagination.
Did I say event didn't happen?
Doesn't require event to happen.
Yeah.
No, the
imagination
doesn't require it to happen.
Guruji, isn't it
possible?
Guruji, isn't it possible that I, in my dream, I went to Paris and saw Chamundi Hills there?
You can.
Yeah. So this is also a dream where I can cook things and imagine whatever I want.
Oh, do you think you don't do that?
I do. I do.
Don't you do that? You
I
do that.
But the moment awareness, the moment
awareness
comes, it's imagination. You are not suffering. The suffering is happening only because you are recording. You are recollecting only your experience.
The suffering is
otherwise
happened.
The moment I know
the suffering is
having a
suffering is nothing work. Suffering has nothing to do with the event. Suffering is because you are confusing yourself with the body and mind.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Once you understand you are not the body and mind, every
there's
event
no
is
suffering. That is Christ.
I understood. But still one question, Guruji. If you say Sakshi doesn't do anything,
why does it exist?
If the Sakshi doesn't do anything, sits and watches, imagines.
This question is coming because Sakshi exists. Otherwise, you won't have this question also. So you cannot ask a question of existence.
Correct.
Existence is existence. Okay. Why existence is like that? You can't give answer.
Correct.
I am trying to explain what's happening right now.
But another question is that why it imagines.
It has to exist. No.
Why it imagines you don't have answer. It's imagination of power, like sun has the power of light. Okay. So I don't deny that something event happened in your life. Okay. But all events happened in the part of your point of view, Sakshi, at this moment.
Yes.
Okay. And Sakshi's point of view, at this moment something happens, next moment something happens. There's nothing called memory. It appears and disappears. From Sakshi's point of view. Just appear
from
and disappear.
Point of view, yes.
Okay, that's the only reality part of you. Now, from unreality, you have to explain the reality. Where I'm not the Sakshi, now I'm thinking I'm the body. Now I have to accommodate my memory. So the memory is one is permanent aspect is coming from Sakshi. Okay, then the moment I say I am appearing, disappearing, Sakshi is the only thing permanent. Then where is the memory? Then I have to say the memory is only because of the imagination at this moment. There's no other way memory can be explained.
All functional memory is also imagination.
Absolutely.
Surgeon is operating by.
How do I drive the car, Guruji?
Imagination. That's exactly what
I
told you.
So
I'm
picking up the skill then and there.
The imagination part. Okay. He is saying there is something called memory.
So in my dream, I am able to fly a aeroplane.
Yeah.
Same thing here.
Yeah.
You
are not recording.
Just what is it?
Okay, this is a dream. I am imagining I am Ashwini and I am doing all these things.
Yeah.
So very next moment, I can also imagine I am somebody else and I am maybe flying the air or something.
You can.
So you can keep thinking different things and we accept it.
Yes.
So in the this state, in this not the dream state, the conscious state, is it possible that we imagine a perfect world and
what is perfect world
or whatever we imagine that there is no pain and there is no suffering.
Why should
and
it really I mean there are people
pain, what is suffering.
So you can imagine so many things, sir, and people do imagine all the revolutions of the world. Russian revolution and all. They want to make a perfect world. Okay, all these missionaries, they say one day the whole world will be chained. Okay, so there you can imagine that also.
No, so it could happen that very next moment something else could happen.
It can.
And I believe it's true.
Yeah. See, the problem is not I believe. The Sakshi is always nothing changes happening. The movie is changing.
So the movie could keep changing.
The green is there.
It can change.
Guruji.
Okay.
Now,
and it does. It does change. Okay. As your understanding, deeper understanding of life changes. So if you think something, something else will change suddenly. Okay, it does. And this is actually what you call power of intention and all those things, lot of telepathy and all they say. So a lot of power of consciousness there. I mean, I have myself have experienced many times. The moment you think something which is drastically will change. Okay. Right now, all these things are not happening to you because you want to protect yourself by imagining you are a body. You want to limit yourself because our fear is not because we are limited. Okay? Our limitation is because of fear. Oh my, some original sentence came from my mouth. Isn't poor word, I don't know. So you are making yourself limited because you are afraid that something, anything can happen. Okay, your fear is making you limited. It's not the other way. Limitation is not making you fearful.
That is part of the script, sir. Part of the imagination.
Part of the imagination.
What we are in our end.
So you have unlimited powers of imagination. So when you go to saint or Mahatma, they say this will happen. They'll say this will happen. So that will happen because it is created that moment. You can also do that. But only thing is, you have to loosen your concept that I am the body. Okay? The moment you say I am the body, you are stuck in time and space and limitation.
So the imagination is part of the Sakshi, no? It's not the part of the character, no? So if I imagine, I as a body mind, if I imagine, it will not happen.
No. The imagination is, actually Sakshi has a dream.
Yes.
The body mind is nothing but a dream of Sakshi.
Yes.
Right? Maya is nothing but dream of
yes.
Brahman. In the dream of Brahman, who is participating?
His character.
Sakshi.
Yes.
Sakshi only is participating in Chidabhasa.
Yes.
Now the Chidabhasa is putting a limitation on himself. Chidabhasa has a powers. Imagination power, creative power, all those things. But putting a limitation. Okay. Now, the moment you remove the limitation, the many things can happen. But we are not speaking of the removing the limitation and achieving siddhis. We are speaking of going back to the original, which is Sakshi.
No, siddhis are intentional imagination, like I want to do like this, I should be like this, you should be like that. Or is there a loosening of your imagination that I...
Loosening of your identity.
Identity. So automatically that imagination, whatever...
Loosening of your identity.
Makes it automatically without obstacles.
Obstacles. Loosening of your identity is what is called siddhis.
No, but here, no,
sages
say, no, that it should happen like this.
That's because they are speaking from a different identity, not a body mind identity. They are knowing, they are actually speaking from, you can speak from body mind identity, you are speaking from energy identity, you are speaking from consciousness identity. In consciousness identity, you don't speak, silenced. In energy identity, this can, everything is flowing.
Sir, does it mean that siddhi, in that case also, is a higher level of imagination only?
Yes, that's right.
But also the imagination.
That's
the
right.
Stretch of imagination is
that's why in this class,
order.
In this class, I don't teach siddhis. I'm only speaking. This whole talk is to tell you that only Sakshi is real. This nothing about siddhis. Only digression.
Akashic records.
Guruji,
all imagination. Akash no illa, records no illa.
Now at this moment, I'm imagining that I've come to a class and that I am Sakshi. Okay, you're teaching that I am Sakshi and I'm not the body. Now in the next moment, what if the entire history changes, the thought changes, and I go, I forget about everything and I go back and live in ignorance again.
You have no problem, no? Person who is in ignorance has no problem, no?
Yeah, but...
See, there are two. Sakshi has no problem. Person is in ignorance has no problem.
Yeah.
No, but what about this person?
I think I'm the body. And
no, that person, he says, I have become ignorant. Then who has a problem? The only person, the problem only will ask the question, no? Sakshi has no problem. Person who is ignorant, no problem. How you can be ignorant? From wisdom to ignorance cannot possible.
Reverse
illa. Reverse agala. Okay? You cannot reverse. No, 8 into 8 is how much?
64.
Now reverse it, forget it. Jnana cannot be reversed in that sense. Okay? From ignorance you can come to jnana. From jnana you cannot go to ignorance. Reverse way. Something happens to your brain, it's okay. But the mind is the one who has taken the data from the brain. Nothing happens to that. Mind means finally it's consciousness. So nothing happens to that.
What does karma function if there is
a... Karma is in the world of dream. As long as you are dreaming, the karma is real. The moment you come out of the dream, karma is unreal. What so that today was heavy topic or what? You understood? Now Sudha has understood. Let us give a big round of applause. Now you have to explain to other people. Even I have not understood. You explain to me. What did you understand, Sudha?
I understood that there is something called memory every second in our life. Always you are recalling, you are living in the present, recalling something from the past. All actions in the present are modified because of your memories.
Right.
So today you introduce this concept that there is nothing like memory. Okay?
Yes.
You are actually consciousness.
Yes.
Or the real I.
Right.
For the real I, something happens and disappears.
Right.
So for the real I, there is no memory, there is no past, there is no future.
Nothing.
Only present.
Present.
But you, that is this body-mind complex, keeps taking something from the past and saying that I did that or that happened to me or I want to do this in the future or I would like to be this. So what is this? We are asking, what is this? Is it not a memory? If it didn't happen, it happened. It is real. You can't call it false. That is what we are all thinking. But you are saying that it is false because it just happened and it is over.
Over.
It is over. But you are dragging it.
Yes.
To the now. Or from the now you are postulating something into the future. And why is all this happening? It is happening because of something called imagination.
Exactly.
And imagination is the power of the...
Consciousness.
Consciousness.
Exactly.
This whole game is...
Moment to moment consciousness is... The consciousness is creating the past and present and future. Okay, it's creating. Okay? Using the imagination power. Now, it's not a memory power. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
We are calling it memory.
Ah.
We have given it the name memory.
Memory.
It's all the game of imagination.
There is a please understand difference between the memory and imagination. The moment you say memory, okay, it's something permanent. Now, you cannot get rid of. Then you'll do a lot of struggle to erase the memory and get rid of vasana. Okay? Whole of spiritual science, how do you get rid of my memory and vasana? The moment you understand it's a prayer of power of imagination, nothing is there in the past, the current. When you start living in the present moment, forgetting about everything, all your suffering, everything is gone.
So ultimately, there is no.
So how does this work for somebody who is like having a chronic disease? So I am suffering from 35 years now. I have a chronic disease. So how does this?
Who is I? Again, my question is, who is I?
The body mind.
The body mind.
So 10 days back, who is what you call as body mind intellect I? Today your body mind intellect is it same?
But the hospital records say I have from 35 years.
The hospital record is also hospital same. See, you the problem is not.
How do I apply this and get over?
Very
the
simple question, my dear.
Treatment.
When you say I, 10 days back, 10 years back, 1 year back, is that I is there now?
But it's the same
same eye which has evolved to this, Noguruji.
It is not same eye.
It's the same body which has come to this level, right?
This is where here, the no, point you are missing. It is not the same body one day back up.
Correct. But right. That keeps changing and it's come to this.
No, Guruji, uh-huh. This fresh thought says...
So you have to understand the difference between the memory and imagination, recreation. Okay? So now, all your thinking is going based on the memory concept. Something called memory is there. I am the same guy. Okay? Now your whole thing you have to reorient. It is happening at this moment. Okay? Yes! There seems to be a history created, but the history is getting created because of my power of imagination, not because there is something called history. Okay? I'll tell you how it will affect your life, change your life. Every moment you have a total freedom emerges. Okay? You are not a prisoner of the past. Okay? This moment my life is getting created. Okay? So, it is a total freedom which starts coming. Otherwise, we are a prisoner of our what happened earlier. Okay? So now let us come back to her question. Somebody is having a 35 years of history of some disease, chronic disease. So, the person who was there 35 years back and the person who is there, are they same? There is not even a single similarity between the persons.
But the disease increased. Even the disease is not same. It has gone to higher degrees now.
But for whom?
For the body.
Body is not same.
Yeah, it has increased.
But then,
no
why
the
disease
has gone to advanced.
The disease is existing because you are identifying with the body, not with the consciousness. Okay? So the moment you think that you don't have freedom because you are stuck with the body, mind and memory, the moment you understand I have freedom, the disease may disappear. That's why there's a book called Biology of Belief by who is author? Okay? The biology of belief. He says anything, any disease can disappear at any point of time. It's depend on your belief, not depend on the disease.
I'm getting it from Amazon today. Law
of attraction also.
It's also imagination.
Slightly different. Okay. But biology of belief, okay, what happens was.
Does the book exist?
Yes.
Bruce Lipton. The guy called Bruce Lipton. Okay. So, the guy called Bruce Lipton has written a book. So, there are many diseases which they say is because of the genes. Your genes are there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Hereditary.
So, now the Bruce Lipton says the disease is not caused by genes. The genes are nothing but memory. That is exactly what I am saying. So that has to be triggered by your belief, consciousness. So that triggers the disease. Now if your belief is changed, the disease will change.
That reminds me, Guruji, you have sent a talk regarding the cancer.
Yes.
You said food, air and
emotions.
Food and air, you have explained it clearly. Now please explain about the part of the emotions. Like this is very well connected.
Okay, so we are getting into some other field, but the point for I'm trying to tell you have to start thinking in a different way if you want to become free. If you keep on thinking the old way, then you are stuck. So you are thinking based on the memory and I am the body way. The moment you start thinking I am consciousness and this is creation, then your life will be very different. Okay, I'll tell you one example which happened, I have seen. Okay, this cancer, this thing, it has come. They talk him because one cancer patient wanted to begin healing. For that, I give him the talk. Okay, I don't want to get into healing and miracles, but I'll tell you what happened. One of my students in Chennai, I had gone to Chennai. So, I go once in the office time. Once in a while, I go. So, then his mother was waiting there for me. Mother is 82 or something like that, old woman. She said, you please heal me. I don't know about healing. You can heal me, she said. She has a lymph node cancer. And third stage it has crossed. Third stage. Doctor said no chemotherapy, no radiation therapy. She can't stand. Then she said, you only can heal me. She has a faith on me because of her son's this thing. Then I didn't want to disappoint her. I said, okay, sleep. Then where is the problem? She has a almost like a sort of what do you call her? ball, na? Not lemon, even that tennis ball size, limp node is swollen. So, if somebody is feeling peaceful in my presence, okay, let me do it. I just touched that and I sat in silence, meditation. To my surprise, in 15 minutes, from the tennis ball, it became peanut.
Okay.
Just dissolved.
That faith.
Okay, that belief. So it just dissolved. Okay, it became peanut. I myself was feeling that my hand is moving. I don't know what is lymph node. I don't know what is cancer. Just dissolved into a peanut. Then next day, they invited me next day breakfast. After that she slept. I didn't even talk. She slept for 3-4 hours. Next day I went and then she said, can you please check heal again? I told her, there's no this thing. After that, she lived 3 years without any problem. No surgery, no chemotherapy, no radiation therapy. So, this is actually, once you start changing your understanding about life, your life changes. Right now, you're stuck. Some of you are thinking that memory is real. Memory is not real. Memory is getting created this moment. Now the memory is real. With that understanding, people are doing so many sadhanas. They don't come out of that. They are actually getting into circle.
Stuck. So as you said in the first class itself, all this is for the I.
So what I am trying to explain
how you do it in the present moment. Now with this understanding, so the thoughts keep coming. With memory they keep coming. So how do I...
Who is that I?
Correct.
How do I operate in the present moment with that memory coming up?
Who is that I?
The mind which operates the body.
Who is that I?
The perspective has to change.
I am not asking from the Sakshi point of view, Sakshi. I am asking from the body mind which has to operate in the daily life.
Aray Baba, you cannot ask. You have to ask from reality point of view. You cannot ask from falsehood point of view. Falsehood point of view, whole of your life you have lived. You have lived a false life. You still want to live a false life, you can continue with that.
True.
Huh?
Very true.
Understand? So you'll never get able to get out of diseases. You'll never get able to get out of diseases. At this moment, you have power of consciousness called power of consciousness. With that power of consciousness, you can change the present moment, or you can accept the present moment depending on where you are.
How is it related to desire? Because desire is what you're talking about.
The desire and vasna all are related to past now. It says,
desire in the present only. No?
Desire comes in the present based on your past habit patterns.
Yes.
Right?
If you consider it as past.
Yeah. Now you consider the desire as real, you'll get stuck with that. You understand desire is appeared now. I have a choice to accept or reject it. I have a choice to create something new.
The choice you are telling, we don't have a choice.
We don't have a choice when I consider as body and mind.
When you consider as a Sakshi or consciousness, I don't have a choice.
You consider yourself as Chidabhasa.
Chidabhasa has a choice?
Chidabhasa is connected to Buddhi in one side and Sakshi in the other side.
Okay.
So now you start understanding, I am Chidabhasa. Who understands that?
Chidabhasa.
Chidabhasa understands with the help of Buddhi, intellect. Mm. Without intellect, you can't understand anything. Because it's a combination. So this understanding is appearing that I am consciousness with the buddhi. Now when I am consciousness, you are actually now, instead of you, the intellect was earlier used by ego, now it's being used by Chidabhasa. So then right understanding has emerged. Intellect is a tool. Earlier intellect was a tool used by ego. Now intellect becomes a tool of Sakshi, Chidabhasa. When I say Chidabhasa. So now either you can say, yes, I'll continue with this. Or I want to change this, I can change this for a better.
But when desires are very strong, even if you imagine yourself as consciousness, you are telling you have to understand.
No, you don't have to imagine yourself, you have to understand yourself as consciousness. And you have to do nididhyasa to become free from all this chakra, all this vasanas. Again, you're getting trapped with that.
Vicious circle.
Vicious circle. So start becoming clear that you are the present moment. I am the Sakshi, I am consciousness, I am Chidavasa. Buddhi and body and mind are my instruments. And I have the power of Sakshi, a power of consciousness called imagination. So that I can change it.
The knowledge which you told that what we think that we had a past and all that, it is actually imagination. So
yes.
It is not a fact.
It's not a fact.
That knowledge should be there when that desire comes up.
No. See, you don't have to, knowledge is not required. You have to learn again and again to remain as Sakshi. Remember as Sakshi. You have to be a Sakshi but operate in the present. The whole point is you have forgotten your Sakshi and you have become body and mind. Now the entire range, I am the Sakshi, I am Chidavasa, I am the body and mind, I am the operative. This thing, then you are the holistic, whole person. Otherwise you are partial. Your problem is you are near partial.
But is it right? It is also a desire to get rid of desire. No? So is it right actually to desire that I should not have, or
no,
it should
no.
be like a
the,
consciousness?
The question here is, I am consciousness means you don't have to do anything. Okay? Now you say, no, I am consciousness but I have to do something. Then you do something better, no?
But will it that help it in realizing, I mean, better? If you
realizing so
that you reduce the desires and all that. Normally this
you
is
don't reduce the desires, you get nana, desires will reduce by themselves. Okay, so that's my principle is there's a whole scriptures the teaching of this thing is develop vairagya and then get realization. I say no, get realization then vairagya will come.
Correct.
Reverse. So the teaching of scriptures is detach and then attach. I'll say attach and then detach. Detachment will happen. As you become more and more get attached to Atma, the detachment will happen. Okay, all that I'm saying is, you don't have to, the freedom comes to you the moment you start realizing this moment is appearing. Okay? A thought, feeling, thought, emotion has appeared. It has appeared. Now, I have the ability either to accept it or reject
deny.
It. Why I should accept or reject it? Because anyway, it's mithya. Then I have the ability to create something different at this moment. So if you don't accept that, if you think the memory is the reality, then you are stuck.
How can I create a different one?
For
then
you
understand.
You can always
when you understand what is there is mithya, unreal.
I don't generate thoughts, right? So how can I create a new one?
The thought has appeared to you.
Yeah. If I reject that, I reject the thought.
Either, you just don't have to reject, you just observe it.
Ignore.
Okay? So then thoughts are coming, one by one it comes. Then disappear, that momentum will go down.
Yeah.
Then you are free.
Hmm.
Then your creativity flows, you can create something. Why do you think I can create, every day morning I sit up and create something new?
So you mean to say, if at all you want to create something,
yes.
Create consciously.
Consciously the creation happens.
Yes.
That is power of imagination. Now the power of imagination is using, you are using it to get, you are binding yourself into a knot. Is it too much or is anybody understood? Or,
no, I understand now.
Sir, actually what my clarification is that if something, desire comes, so there are three options. One is that, okay,
accept.
Accept that desire, okay, no, accept that, okay, this desire has come, okay, I will do that. Or second is that, no, I will not do it. The third is that, as you told the Sakshi, okay, I am the consciousness and desire has come. So whatever, even if I do or not do, irrespective of that, I have to accept it that, yeah, I am a consciousness, it will come and it will go.
Yes, that's what Ramana Maharshi does. So he says, I don't care, let the desire come, I am sitting. Okay, Sri Krishna says.
No, action.
Sri Krishna says. Sri
reaction to that desire.
No, I am saying. Ravana says, desire has come, I will have to kidnap Sita, he will kidnap Sita. He has succumbed to desire. Sri Krishna also some desire comes, he says reject it. Then he says, I can create something, I can create some dharma. So he'll do it. Okay? Ramana Maharshi says, desire comes, I don't do anything, I just sit.
So irrespective of the reaction is the point of, from which point you are acting.
Yes.
Even if you are rejecting or accepting, more important is the point of, from which point you are doing it.
Correct. So, see the desire for selfish reason is one thing. Desire for unselfish reason, nothing. Shri Krishna, when some desire comes to him, he may just reject it and say, for dharma, I'll do this. That's a desire. Dharma is also a desire. Then you'll do it. Ramana Maharshi says, any desire comes, I'll not move. Okay? So like that, your degree of freedom increases. Whether you use the degree of freedom or not, I don't know. But you're not a slave of the body mind complex, the time and space. Ashwini, did you understand? Now tell me, how does it change your life?
So every moment I can think I want to do something better. That is only if I'm thinking that I'm conscious. If I think I'm a body mind, then
you're stuck.
I'm falling through the
trap. You are a prisoner.
So
right?
If I think that I'm consciousness, then
and the amount you are able to do, okay, you can do miracles depending on the limitation of the ignorance which is there in your mind. Still at the back of the mind, I am the body, my limitations. That ability will also be limited. Your freedom starts increasing, but the identity has to dissolve proportionately. Are you getting what I'm saying? The more your self-identity dissolves, the more freedom is there in what you do. You become free from karma. This is called karma bandhana in the mukti. Karma means past result will give the present, past actions will give the present result. When you are breaking from free from karma, past doesn't matter. This moment matters. And whatever I do in this moment, no karma gives to me because I am Sakshi. So you become free from bondage of karma. Otherwise you are continuously living in a memory and karma domain. Vasu? What? Yes or no? Clear? Shunai mom, silent.
Living in the present is the...
No, living in the present, but not as a body and mind. As a body and mind, you are still...
Yeah.
As you become conscious,
yeah.
So then you understand that your degree of freedom is more and more. That's called karma.
That is disconnecting from the karma, living in the present.
Living in the present.
That's all that you have to do.
And karma is coming to us because of the memory. Impressions,
yeah.
Vasanas. So you are getting rid of that, not by purifying, okay, doing something.
Yeah. That's not
but through dnana.
That clarity I wanted, chitta shuddhi, what is that chitta shuddhi? So
this is the real chitta shuddhi.
Yeah, yeah. Disconnect from that. Yeah.
In the clear day? Silence. Huh? Alapa, new yaro. Sakshi. Chidabhasana is Sakshi. Chidabhasana and Chidabhasana are not going to be able to do Sakshi. Sakshi is the prapancha, illa, desha, illa, kala, illa, yalla, maya. Presently, you are not disappear. Past illa. So, na deha is the past bantu, concept bantu. You are already entered into time. Okay? Now, then you have to explain the time in the form of memory. Right? But if you look at it from Sakshi's point of view, memory is not real. Then all that you can say is my imagination power is creating this moment. Right? You have to create a memory. You have to create a memory. You have to create a Sakshi. You have to create a memory. But you have to create a memory. You have to create a moment to moment. You have to create a moment. Only imagine. It's my Shakti. You have to create a So, how do you live it depends. Are you living as body and mind or are you living as memory? That makes a difference. Anyone is clear?
Are you living as body and mind or are you living as memory?
Sakshi. Body and mind, memory is... When you say I am body and mind, memory is your reference. Not Sakshi. When you are Sakshi, my imagination power is the movement. Correct? Which angle you are looking at life, that angle opens up. Now if you are living as a body and mind, you cannot escape from memory. You cannot escape from karma. You are stuck. Okay, the moment you understand I am Sakshi, I am Chidabhasa, then power comes back to you. This is my power of consciousness which is manifesting at this moment. Are you clear? So now you are making a complete break from your
pattern.
Are you clear? Is it clear to everybody? Can you proceed further?
So, a multiple personality disorder. So, there's little loose with respect to identity.
No, they're stuck to
playing around.
No, they're stuck to identity. They're stuck to identity. Okay, they're stuck to identity. At a moment, they are not a realized Atma. Okay, they don't know their Atma. They're stuck to identity. Now the identities keep shifting. Ashte. They don't have control over which identity is coming at what point of time. But see, multiple identity personality disorder, don't you have that? Huh? All of us have it. One moment I become my wife, she is just saying, I am son of, I am mother. Now I am telling you, Sakshi, she is saying, I am the mother. So, actually, multiple personality disorder, what psychologist is, only 2% or 1 or 2%. I say you have million personalities. And no psychologist will be able to solve the problem. So, Sudha, if you understand this, you can live your life in the present moment. You start becoming free from the past and future. Okay? The more you become free, the more life will be flowing. Now, life is stuck because of karma and vasanas and impressions. This is called freedom from karma. Okay? Jnanagni.
Jnanagni.
Dagda karmani.
Dagda karmani.
The fire of knowledge burns karma. Nothing else will burn karma. The fire of knowledge is I am Atma. I am consciousness. What is happening in this moment is my creative power. If you understand, you are becoming free. If you say, this is my karma, my past is coming and catching up with me, you are a body. And clear a day?
Is it the creation of...
No, Krishna Mahatir, you have two sentences last time. Previous bachelor held me with you.
ಅಯ್ಯೋ ನಿಮ್ ಜೀರ್ಣ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕಾಗಲಿಬೇಕಪ್ಪ
ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ಗೆ ಬರ್ತಿರ್ಲಿ
ನೀವು ಜೀರ್ಣ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅದು ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ ನೀವು ಡೈಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕಲ್ಲ ಈಗಲೂ ಇನ್ನು ಡೈಜೆಷನ್ ಪೂರ್ತಿ ಆಗಿದೆ ನಂಗೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ
ಜೋಕ್ ಇದೆ ಅಪ್ಪನ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಹಸಿವಾಗಿತ್ತು ಚಪಾತಿ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಡು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳ್ತಾನೆ ಹೆಂಡತಿ ಚಪಾತಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಕೊಡ್ತಾಳೆ 10 ಚಪಾತಿ 11 ಚಪಾತಿ ತಿನ್ಮೇಲೆ ಹೊಟ್ಟೆ ತುಂಬುತ್ತೆ ಮೊದ್ಲೇ ಈ 11 ಚಪಾತಿ
ಹತ್ತು ಚಪಾತಿ ಉಳಿತಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿರ್ಬೇಕೋ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ವೋ ನಾನು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಇದನ್ನ ನಾನು ಬೇರೆ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಈ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಯಾಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ದೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತು ನನಗೆ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಬೇರೆ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ I have told in different ways, but that is no...
We have also told beautifully about that neerali one drop ink bidaga. You cannot remove it, but you can only dilute it. Atara gnana anno idanna haki haki adu. That told very beautifully.
ಈ ಥಾಟ್ ಬಂದ್ ಹೋಗೋದು ತುಂಬಾ ಸಲ ನೀರ್ ಬಾಟ್ಲ್
ಬಾಟಲ್
ಅಲ್ಲ ಇದ್ರ
ನೋಡಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಹೋಯ್ತು
ತಿರ್ಗಾ ಬಾಟಲ್ ಅಂದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ದಿಸ್ ಅನದರ್ ಥಾಟ್
ಇಟ್ಸ್
ರೈಟ್ So the more you start going back to self, more you start living in the present, more you start living in now, you'll start feeling freedom. Otherwise, now your suffering is because you are feeling congested. You are feeling pressurized by the time, space and karma. My dear, there is no karma for you. There never was a karma. Okay?
That's imagination.
With your perfect imagination, you have created a husband, which will solve your karma.
That is an imperfect imagination.
No, that is a very perfect imagination because you have created such a perfect husband. You have come on Sunday morning to this class. Okay? If you have created an imperfect husband, you would not have come to this class, you would have gone to a movie. Okay? So, please understand, any suffering in your life is not because of your karma, it's because of your creation. Okay, please understand. Oh, I am suffering in life. Your suffering in your life is your creation to wake up from the dream called Maya. Okay, it is not because somebody did something to you. it is because you created beautiful. You are very smart. You create such a complicated structure called husband or wife to get up from the dream called Maya. That's why all the days.